Greetings, Church. Satan just came out several times. I was just about to move for this old white man, and he just cursed at me, I guess because I didn't move fast enough. This is my second video. The first one I erased, the second one I erased, so this is really my third video. And I am outside of the library, and as I was saying in my video, I just came back from the 24 hours, and before that, I had done some, I had done my laundry on 79th Street. I'm just starting the ministry right now. It is 3:15, and so I'm kind of behind on a lot of things. The bibliography for 2019 works, and as far as preaching is concerned, I did that last night for the 8x8 that I was given by Joint, and the passage that I read is from the Gospel of Mark, Mark chapter 8. And hold on a second, when I was about to do this earlier, T-Mobile cut off the telephone so that I would not read this passage of the Bible talking about Jesus asking the question, "Who do men say I am?" It's in that passage of Mark. Let me see if I can find it here real quickly. I spoke to them, and I also did something I've never done before. I opened up the tent right in front of them so they could see exactly what the tent looked like. So they could see exactly what the tent looked like when it's open. And I also added the title of the tent in there. It's the tent ministry. So the title that I added on the tent ministry was the New Testament Church Tent Ministry. To God be the glory. And then I think underneath that I wrote Walk with God Ministries Outreach, and then Kevin E. Duclerin, Pastor Preacher. And I explained to them that I'm a preacher outside of the tent, inside of the tent, I'm a pastor. I had a young woman, I think her name was Darian, who came. She might have been a rep of Carol and perhaps the Queen, I'm not exactly sure. She wept and she prayed, and I basically encouraged her to read the Bible, go home, read the scriptures, and talk to Jesus. I also encouraged the city to do the same. So, you know, I didn't tell her anything to do. I didn't tell her anything that I wouldn't have told anyone else. After that, I went to McDonald's across the river to see if I can buy some coffee. McDonald's did something that I didn't like. They're Hispanics. They're short is Hispanics. Keep cutting me down. You know, I just thought it was uncalled for, so I didn't even go and buy the coffee from them. I tried buying it from Burger King, but the door was closed there too. So it looked like they had a setup, but I didn't care. I just walked away. In any case, so I didn't get the coffee from there, and as a result of it, I was hit. I had parked the tent on Grand between Morrison and Morrison, Morrison going east and Morrison going west. And it was about midnight when it was parked there. I was sexually assaulted 5 times. I was cut on my devil's crack, that's what I'm calling it. And I was also cut on my left, not the shin, but right next to, not, you know, to the shin area. And I was sexually assaulted 3 times. So 5 times I was offended. And of course they broke into the tent, that's trespassing. So that's 6, and then who knows what else they did in there. I think they might have done something else, like sabotage one of my piece of property, but I can't remember everything, you know? Today I went to McDonald's again to get some coffee, and I was cut down again. So there's something going on McDonald's, in McDonald's, with the workers on the Hispanic side, where they always feel the need to cut me down. I'm not sure what's going on. It doesn't feel right, you know, going to McDonald's these days. It's not the food, it's these, and not necessarily the service, but it's the relationship between myself and these Hispanics. They have the tendency to just come out with an attitude, a chip on the shoulder, like I'm their subordinate, I'm their subjugate, and I need to submit to all of that. Anyway, long story short, that's pretty much been what's been going on here on this end. I think that's pretty much it for an update, but I'm hoping that nobody does anything to the tent. I did rip the bag, unfortunately, when I was pulling it out. I didn't know that was going to happen, so I have to sew it. But apart from that, I think it's a good tent that I might be able to use, you know, while I do ministry here in Portland. Somebody asked me directly whether or not I was homeless. And as many times as I've come out on this community explaining my situation with grace, you know, it's like, I don't think I should have to respond to that. And of course, yesterday, as I had made mention, I did talk to the district attorney about that case. And I don't know if they did anything, called. And most likely, if the tent was their response, I'm not exactly sure if they're even going to move forward to see whether or not I can get a copy of that letter. That letter, I think, might be my best bet to start life all over again. As a Christian who's been outcast, you know, I don't know if Grace is a satanic church, and I don't know if they're a satanic seminary, you know, babbling rather than expositing. I'm not exactly sure. You know, there's something not right about Grace. I used to trust Grace and love Grace, but now I take a step back because of what Grace has done these last 24 years. So pray for Grace. You know, if Satan is holding them captive to do his will, pray that God would deliver them. If MacArthur is not in love with Jesus, you know, his first love, like it says in Revelation, you know, you have lost your first love, then somebody pray that God would lead him back to Christ and subject himself to him again as his first love, as would be the case for all of us. Anyway, I will check in with you at another time. Keep me in your prayers as I keep you in mine. And pray for the city of Portland so that they understand that God is talking to them through the preaching of the word and the gospels. I was going to read the gospel of Mark, but I don't have my glasses. And I'm taking too much time as it is right now to even talk to you. So I will talk to you at a later time. I'll read the gospel for you at a later time. If you want to know what it says, read it. And pray for Darian and everybody who heard the message last night. Okay? And God be with you.